Hello guys, and welcome to episode 7 of my Shamrock Rovers career mode. And I want to start off by showing you the coaches. We have signed 4 coaches, well 3 more upon the additional one. And as you can see, the training looks pretty sick. All areas of coaching is at least 2.5 stars, which is great in my opinion. That is world class for a club with the reputation of Shamrock Rovers. But let's get on, have a look at the fixtures, and we started from here, and we've done alright. So Pats Athletic started off the season 3-2, it was a good game. Ian Byrne, I decided to start him over Mark Quigley, because he's been doing brilliantly. He's 4-4 this season in the league, and look in the friendlies, 9 goals in 5 games, and one of them was off the bench, so he's a natural born goal scorer. He's going to be one of the best regens, I think. If he gets trained properly, he's going to be a star. He's going to be a Shamrock Rovers legend. I'm hoping I can keep hold of him. Where were we? Derry City. We lost. And this is where I thought, oh no, is it going to be the same thing again? Are we going to be playing catch-up all season? But, fortunately, not. Because after the draw in the All-Ireland Cup, which I'm not that bothered about, we beat Dundalk, drew Sligo Rovers, which wasn't that bad. And when I look at Dundalk, you can see Teji Savanier is doing well this season, getting in a few goals. But we started to get in a rhythm towards the end. We beat Cork, who are having a great season. Drogheda we beat, we've struggled against them before. And Shelbourne we beat. A lot of goals there. Ian Byrne is outperforming Mark Quigley at the moment, but let's have a look at the league before I show you the player stats. We're sitting second behind Derry. Cork are looking quite sick as well, but Derry having their strong start as usual. Yet again though, I think they will drop off towards the end of the season. I think Cork will be there towards the end of the season. This isn't pre-recorded or anything. I'm not further ahead in the game. This is a true prediction. I think Cork will be there at the end of the season. I think Derry City will drop off. I think they'll finish fourth. And I think it's going to be between us, Sligo Rovers, and Cork. Because Cork have done a good bit of business. If I show you here, they've sold a regen for 300k after having him for less than a month. So they've gone good there. Looking good. They're looking good. But I'm happy with seconds because we stomp it at the end of the season once we're all settled in. The players are doing well. Let me show you the stats in the league so far. Top goal scorer, Ian Byrne. He's, for a 17-year-old, he's smashing it. Great performance. Teji Savanier as well now. He's settling into that right winger role. Still unconvincing after a year of being trained there. He's played there pretty much every game, but now his stats are looking a bit more tasty. 3 goals, 4 assists, 6 games. Going to be his season, I think. Bryce Fontaine, you know, he's been solid. The centre backs are really the strongest area now, I think. If you look at the average rating, Bryce Fontaine, Teddy Kayombo, he's come in and he's done a great job. Paride Bianco, you know, it wasn't a one off season, he's still performing and he's growing nicely now. He actually looks like a good centre back, because before he didn't look that good, but he performed well, so it's a bit confusing, but He's performing now. He's growing as well. And the other centre back, where is he? Mbabu. Haven't played him much actually. His stats in the cup. Alright. I'm not going to prioritise him. I'm prioritising the players I've got signed to the club. He's going to be back up in Mbabu. But not bad. Assists. Teji Savanier smashing him. But Ian Byrne, you've got to give him credit where it's due. I also want to show you guys something else. The Premier League. Something's wrong with that. Have you spotted it yet? United. 14th. David Moyes is still there. But I don't know what's going wrong. I don't know what's going wrong with the game. United struggling against relegation. Oh, it's a close season though. Top place, 59 points. 32 games. It's a bit weird one. But I think the Premier League might end up like this in the future. because it is getting so close now, I think, in the middle of the table. The teams are catching up, but I think, realistically, United and probably Chelsea are going to run away with it in the future. Sad as it is, Arsenal and United might be there. I don't know, but I think we're going to have closer seasons in the next 10 years, IRL. But back to our league, the challenge is going alright. Europe's the focus this season. We've got some average games coming up. I'm just trying to win them, get storm for them, and we'll get to Europe. It's all about Europe now. We are definitely growing as a club. We are getting big players want to come to us. Rory Delap is one of them. I can't think of the other one. But we've had some Premier League, you know, big reputation players wanting to come to us. So it is impressive. We're definitely growing. Our season tickets have gone up by about 20% as well. So we're getting there. If we keep going at this rate exponentially, we're on the right track. Richie Ryan came back from injury, he's doing well. But the one player who's growing beautifully, James Chambers, he's going to be an Irish legend, a Shamrock Rovers legend. I want to keep him here until he retires. He's going to play that role beautifully. Tune in next episode, guys. Hopefully we'll catch up. Might have a few European games. I'm not sure when it starts. Actually, you probably won't. Actually, you might. I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to try and storm through this because I want to get these first few seasons done quickly. Because this is not about the gameplay, this series. It's all about the challenge. And I want to get this going quickly as possible. So that's why you're not seeing as much gameplay and highlights. I'm going to try and show you the highlights or maybe even a live match for the European games because they're more important. But, you know, I want this series to last at least 10 seasons before FM14 comes out. But on that note, I'll see you later, guys. Tune in next time. Bye.